friends, in this video we will study the interfacing of the 8085 microprocessor with the programmable interrupt controller 8259. So let's start with our topic. We know that this 8259 IC, which is known as the Programmable Interrupt Controller or PIC, this controller, it is used by the 8085 microprocessor to provide the priorities of the interrupts, and also when the 8085 it is handling multiple interrupts, then this controller is used. Okay, so if we see that suppose this is our 8085 microprocessor, this is 8259 PIC, and these are the various systems which want to interrupt the microprocessor, okay, which are interrupting the microprocessor. Now when several interrupt requests are given to the microprocessor, then microprocessor first it has to decide that which interrupt it has to execute the first and which is at the second position. So it has to decide the priority among these interrupts. Okay, now when these input output devices now when this 8085 it is deciding the priority, so it is busy in doing that task. So it is always indulged in these multiple interrupt systems. So to relieve the 8085 microprocessor from the task of deciding the priorities and to handle these multiple interrupts, we use the controller 8259. So these controller, these input output devices, they first send the request to the 8259, and with respect to these requests, 8259 will give a request, or it is going to interrupt the microprocessor. Microprocessor, in respect to this, it will give an acknowledgement signal, and then the interrupts which are given by the input output devices, they will be executed. Okay, so this is how the 8085, 8259 and the peripheral devices, they work in conjunction with each other. So here in this video, we are studying the interfacing of the 8085 microprocessor with the 8259, that how these two are connected with each other, or how these two communicate with each other. Because interfacing, it means that it's a communication path between two components. So here the two components are the 8085 and the 8259, and how they are communicating with each other, that is called the interfacing. Okay, so first step will be that the 8259, it is going to receive the request, interrupt request, from the input output devices. So to receive these requests, the 8259, it has a register which is known as the interrupt request register. This register, it is an 8-bit register, and it has 8 bits starting from IR0 to IR7. So these 8 interrupt request bits, these are connected to the 8 interrupt, these 8 input output devices, it can be connected, or it can handle 8 interrupt requests at a time. Okay, so if any of these 8 bits, it is set, means it is set to 1, it means that that interrupt request has been generated. Suppose like if IR5 is equal to 1, it means that this request has been generated. Okay, so this interrupt request register, it is going to store the request signals from all the interrupt inputs. Okay, so that is the first step of this interfacing. Then this IR, this interrupt request register, when the request has been given to the 8259, now 8259 it is going to decide the priorities. Okay, so for deciding the priority, the 8259, it has the priority resolver register. And this register decides the priority among the 8 interrupts. So these interrupts were the IR0 to IR7. So if suppose like 3 interrupts are simultaneously occurring at the IRR register. Okay. So at among these IR0 to IR7, suppose IR4, IR6 and IR7. These 3 interrupt requests are simultaneously occurring. Now, among these 3 interrupts, which interrupt is having the highest priority? So, the highest priority interrupt will be first executed, then interrupt which is having the priority at the second step, and the lowest priority interrupt. So, suppose if IR7 is having highest priority, so it will be executed first, then IR6 is having the priority, then IR4. So in this way the interrupts will be executed. Okay, so at the second step this priority will be decided. Now after deciding the priority, we have the register which is the interrupt mask register. Okay, now this register, it contains the information about the interrupts which are masked in by the 8259 or by the microprocessor. So these register, it is also an 8-bit register, and the 8 bits, they are correspondingly representing the 8 interrupts also. So we have suppose IM0 to IM7. Now these 3 interrupts were available, priority is also decided, IR7 is having highest and IR4 is having the lowest. Now suppose that in place of 3-4 interrupts are given at a time, like IR3 and IR2 are also given, but these interrupts, they are masked. If they are masked, means their corresponding bits in this interrupt mask register, that will be set. So for IR2 we will have IM2 and for IR3 we will have IM3. So if these 2 bits are set to 1, it means that these 2 interrupts are also given, but these are masked. Okay, so we have total 5 interrupt requests are there, and out of these 5 interrupt requests, 2 interrupts are masked and 3 interrupts are available, and the priorities among these 3 interrupts is already decided. So in this way the 8085 microprocessor, it gets the information about the pending interrupts and the masked interrupts. Okay, so information is given to the 8085. So what it has to first execute the IR7 interrupt. Now when this request has been generated, priorities is also decided, then the 8259, the programmable interrupt controller, it is going to generate an interrupt output signal, which is the INT interrupt output. This signal will be generated when a valid request is reached to the 8259. So 8259, it is going to generate this signal to interrupt the microprocessor. So this signal will go to the microprocessor, and then the microprocessor, it is going to be interrupted, and in response to this signal, microprocessor is going to generate the INTA bar signal. This is the interrupt acknowledge signal. Okay, so this interrupt acknowledge signal, it will be given to the 8259. You can see that this 8259 has generated this INT. INT was given to microprocessor. Microprocessor generated INTA bar. And then this signal is given to 8259. So this 8259, it is getting the acknowledgement signal that the request has reached to the microprocessor. Okay. Now, 8259, it has to provide the vector address, means the address of the service routine. Because for every interrupt, we have a service routine which is to be executed. Okay, so the address where this service routine is written, that is provided by the 8259 to the microprocessor. Okay, so now the microprocessor, it is going to at that location, that address, it will go to that address and it will execute the service routine. Okay, and then the service routine will be executed. Again, the 8259, that interrupt has been completely accessed by the microprocessor. So now again the 8259, it is going to check that whether any interrupt is available or not. If it is available, then same procedure will be repeated. Okay, so if we want to summarize these steps, that how the communication between the 8085 microprocessor and the 8259 it is taking place, how the sequence of interrupt is taking place. So let's summarize all the points here. We can name it as the interrupt sequence. So first step will be that one or more interrupt request lines IR0 to IR7, they are raised high. Raised high means they are set to 1. That set the corresponding interrupt request register bits. So IR0 to IR7, if any of the bits is set to 1, then their corresponding bits in the interrupt request registers, they will also be set. Okay, so that will be the first step. If more than one interrupt request are generated, then suppose 2 or 3 or 4 requests are generated simultaneously, then priority will be decided, and according to the priority level, the interrupt which is having the highest priority first, that will be executed, and in response to that interrupt request, a signal, INT signal, will be sent to the microprocessor or the CPU. Now when this INT signal is given to the CPU, the CPU is going to acknowledge the request with the INTA pulse. So in response to this INT, CPU is going to generate this pulse INTA, which shows that it has received the request for the interrupt. Now when this INTA signal it is received by the 8259, then the highest priority in service register it is set, and the corresponding in interrupt request register bit is reset. Okay, so suppose that the interrupt request number 6 was generated. So when this is generated, then INT signal will be given to the microprocessor. Microprocessor will generate INTA bar. This signal will be generated. Now when this signal it is received by 8085, then the corresponding bit of this IR6, that is the IS6, means in service register, in the in service register, the information about the interrupt which is currently being executed by the CPU, that is stored. So currently this sixth interrupt is accessed by the microprocessor, so its in service register bit will be set to 1. So IS6 will be set to 1, and again this IRR, that is the interrupt request register bit, will be set to 0. So IR6, it is again made to 0. Okay, so in this way the in-service register bit is set to 1, whereas the interrupt request register bit, it is set to 0. Okay, so that is what I have written in this step number 4, that upon receiving INTA signal, the highest priority in-service register, it is set, and the corresponding interrupt request register bit, it is reset. Okay, now let's come to the fifth point. Now, after this IR6 bit, it is reset, then 8085, it will initiate a second interrupt acknowledge pulse, and during this period, the 8259 IC, it releases an 8-bit pointer onto the data bus from where it is read by the CPU. Okay, so when this occurs, that when this second pulse is generated, then 8259, it is going to give an 8-bit data on the data bus, and that data will be read by the CPU. Okay, so that is the address of where the interrupt service routine is written. So CPU has to jump to that memory location and it has to execute that service routine. Okay, and when the service routine is completely executed, then microprocessor will again return to its current task, current location, and then again it is going to check that whether any interrupt is still available or not. So this completes the interrupt cycle. Because the service routine has been executed by the CPU, so the CPU has again come to its initial position. So the interrupt cycle is completed, service routine has been executed by microprocessor, and the corresponding bit of the interrupt request which was generated, that is IR6 was generated, that has been set to 0. Now this bit can be set to 0 by two methods. One is the end of interrupt command. And second is automatic end of interrupt command. So these are the two modes of operation of the 8259 IC. It can work in end of interrupt mode also, and it can work in the automatic end of interrupt mode also. So when the 8259, it is in end of interrupt mode, then when the interrupt service routine was executed by CPU, so at the end of that service routine, this command is given, end of interrupt command. And that command shows that the service routine has been completely executed, and this request has been completely accessed by the microprocessor. Okay, so the microprocessor or the interrupt cycle has completed its task. Now if the 8259, it is working in the automatic end of interrupt, then the 8259, there is no need of giving any command or any external input. So the 8259 and the microprocessor, they will automatically get to know that the service routine has been completely executed and this bit has to be reset. Okay, so this bit can be reset using the end of interrupt command also and using the automatic end of interrupt mode also. So this was the complete interrupt cycle or the complete interrupt sequence of the 8085 and the 8259. Okay, how they interface with each other, how they communicate, how an interrupt request which is generated, that is accessed by the microprocessor when we have connected 8259 in between the microprocessor and the interrupting device. Okay. So I hope that this topic is clear to you, that how these can be interfaced with each other. Thank you.